Vamos camp. Excitement.
Spaniard. Everybody goes on.
Hands in the air, no raga. Hands in the air, no Ricky. Hands in the air, no Mada. Hands in the air, no. Hands in the air, no Mada. Hands in the air, no. Hands in the air, no.
What we say? We ready.
Former national goalkeeper, now ESPN analyst, Shaka Hislop. Shaka, you're here in Barbados, football again, but in a different context. How does it feel to be back here with the boys again?
It's always good fun to catch up with, you know, former teammates and well, guys who were pulling us back in the day. Just over a semi-competitive game and a couple of drinks, just rekindle some of the memories and some of the good times that fading rather quickly. Yeah, it has been. I mean, I've got quite a schedule right now, and you know, playing football is not something that I don't really have the time to do it anymore. But you know, again, to have the opportunity to be here in a country like Barbados with a lot of friends is an opportunity I couldn't turn down, despite embarrassing myself quite a lot over the course of the day.
Surprised now in terms of football is happening in the footballing world. Surprised at Chelsea's success in the Champions League.
I am. You know, you look at Chelsea, Sydney and Vyas Boas, and you didn't see where Chelsea were going as a team or as a club. Roberto Di Matteo came in and I think had to stop the bleeding. And to do that, he had to get Chelsea playing more defensive. I mean, that's what Chelsea's success, all their successes were built on in the Mourinho days, a solid defense and getting goals when needed. And I think they did that. And I think the criticism that Di Matteo has had to endure since has been a little bit unfair because, again, for me, if it wasn't done, Chelsea still would have finished well outside the top four, wouldn't have won the Champions League, probably wouldn't have won the FA Cup either, and you know, it'd be a trophy-less season and a Europe-less season next, and then I think the club would have a lot more problems.
You look at some of your former teams now, Newcastle, West Ham. What is your take on how these teams have progressed and where they are right now?
Well, for Newcastle right now in particular, I have to say the season they had was exceptional and one I didn't anticipate them having. You look at the signings that part you made, in particular in Bar, and then just as he seemed to go off the ball, they brought in Papi Cisse in January, and I think they struck up a fantastic relationship. And as much note that Papi Cisse got over the 6 months that he was there, I think that was as much about the partnership, the Senegalese being together, and Alan Pardew just realizing how good and how important it was for them. And then, well, to finish up the question, and now, you know, West Ham, who were favourites to get promoted from the Championship, get there through the playoffs in a style that not really becoming of West Ham, and you know, West Ham fans still to this day talk about the Ron Greenwood influence on the football club and on their playing style, and Sam Allardyce, I don't think really embodies that. But they have a task. I think it was more important that they got promoted. They did that, and only they have to survive for a couple of seasons before they really start looking forward, as Newcastle have now done. The thing for me is, as much as everybody has been very quick and very willing to blame Jack Warner for everything and distance themselves from, you know, any impropriety that kind of was originated from him, I think a lot of them enabled it and aren't willing to take credit for it. And I think until people start accepting responsibility for the problems in Trinidad and Tobago football, I don't see how we move past the past. I don't see how things improve, and that for me is the biggest concern, because again, you can't fix the same old problems with the same old faces and the same old thing.
Are you I mean, Max, if you're going to be optimistic, but in terms of our football and the direction that it is in heading right now, do you see us being able to recover from this in due course, maybe a couple of years, 3 years down the road?
Well, we can. I think the crushing blow really is being out of work of qualifying as early as we are. I mean, it's middle of 2012 and we already we out of the work of in 2014 and we've been out for nearly a year now, what, 9 months since we've been knocked out. And maybe that was a weak call that we needed and well, needs to be heeded. But saying so, you know, and I think it's an awfully long time without competitive football, an important competitive football, for us to endure before we start making strides and moving forward.
When you look at what is happening with CONCACAF and the CFU now, what is your take on that in terms of new presidency, new people in charge?
Well, again, needed new faces. Needed new faces, and at least we have that now. We see if they are the right people to take our regional football forward.
There's anybody in terms of coaching a senior national team of Trinidad that we can revert to who's not necessarily a foreigner?
There's nobody I can think of. I continue to be a huge Russell Lathaby fan. I am biased, and I will say as well that the results weren't, I don't think, as good as I'm sure even he expected. But he's got a wonderful brain for the game, and I think needs to be consulted, at least consulted in taking our football forward. As does Dwight Yo. As far as coaches at the local level, I'm not sure. I'm just not in touch with that side of the game. So I couldn't honestly tell you.
Thanks a lot, Shaka. It was a pleasure.
You're very welcome.